In this recording, I want to talk about pagans. Now, I know that the pagan population of the world is diverse. You have pagans in Tibet, pagans in Japan, pagans in Korea, pagans in Peru, Mexico, Canada, and they have their traditions. And those traditions are often related to the religion and the language of their environment, also the history of their ethnic background. But overall, pagans have this thing called pagan thinking, which is really the fact male thinking, because men tend to think this way, but it's a way of thinking that's the fact, but it works. It's a practical way of thinking, but it does not lead you to rely on Christ. That's why it's the fact. All right? It's really eating from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, which is adapting Satan's way of relating to stuff. Now, are pagans by definition Satanists? No. Many don't even care about that guy Satan. They don't even want anything to do with the guy, but they're not aware that their mindset is a reflection of the defect male thinking of Satan. Okay? About pagans. Pagans are, in general, so there are some exceptions, but in general, pagans are paranormally aware. They should be, because they're paranormally active. So when you're paranormally active, you are aware. For example, when you're driving a car, you are aware of the roads, or else you can't be driving a car. So pagans are paranormally aware. Well, there are some dumb pagans around who really don't know what they're doing. You have some exceptions, but in general, pagans are paranormally aware. All right? And because they're paranormally aware, they tend to know these things others don't. Why? Because common people are numbed down in their intuition. Common people teach each other to ignore their natural intuition and to get along with the crowd. That is what common people do. They use threats of violence or threats of social exclusion, which is emotional violence. They use it on each other to secure the collective validation of what we call society. So common people are numbed down. Pagans, on the other hand, are alert. Now, that does not mean that automatically they are right. They are correct because they are alert. They're not right because they're not in line with Christ. Okay? But pagans, they see things as they are. Of course, I know there are exceptions, but in general, they see things as they are. I'm going to give examples now. Let's say you're in high school. Okay? You have two guys that are both 15. One is a pagan, the other is just a commoner. The commoner sees this chick that's 23 passing by. And the chick of 23 smiles at them. And the guy, the commoner of 15, oh dear, you know how he thinks. Especially if you're a man, you know what he's thinking. The pagan sees the chick and he gets horrified. And the commoner, let's call the commoner John, and the pagan called Patrick. John says to Patrick, "Patrick, did you see that chick there? Man, she smiled at us. She's an interested man." But then Patrick tells him, "Hold up, John. Hold up." And then John asks him, "Patrick, well, what is going on, man? How often that does it happen that a 23-year-old chick looks with just interest at you, and you're younger than her?" And then Patrick tells him, "John, that's exactly what I mean. I mean, come on, if she's so attractive, she must have had boyfriends before. She must have had older men being interested in her also. So why is she at 23 interested in teenagers who are still in their development? Who still have to finish high school? Come on, John. That doesn't add up." What's going on? This John just sees what's in front of them. and he goes off in what's in front of him. He gets along with the crowd, and according to the crowd, you must be happy when, as a man, any woman shows interest in you, because for some reason society taught men that you need to earn being liked, you need to earn being acknowledged. So based on this thing of common people, John relates to the situation as, I must be lucky, there must be a good fortune for me. Patrick, at the other hand, who's a pagan and who knows about the spirit realm, when he saw that 23-year-old chick, he felt danger, because his intuition worked perfectly fine. Yes, his body reacted with hormones because he saw an attractive woman, but in his mind, he was alert. And he thought, why are you interested in guys like us? What do you want? Is it because, he was thinking, is it because men your age don't want you anymore? Is it because you're some Jezebel whore that you've abused so many men that now you're so filled with crap that you want younger men without much experience that you can get away with stuff? I mean, that pagan, even though he was not right in his thinking, he was correct. Something didn't add up in the situation. And that chick, that 20-year-old chick, later that pagan found out, because he went to a fortune teller, she used to exploit men up with emotional problems, by taking money away from them. He would promise to remain with them and all of that, and make them all crazy, then she would rob them and she would leave. Now after a while, people found out about her, and she lost all her friends, and now she's a loner. She puts on makeup, high heels, and she walks around as if she has a great life, but she's really a loner. And she has financial issues also. She's living beyond her financial means. So, the pagan found out about this, and the fortune teller also told him, or better, the demons inside the fortune teller who were aware of the situation told him, Patrick, this woman just wants a younger man, maybe around age 20, or anyway, a man that's younger than her, that she can control, upon which she can relieve all her frustrations, because she knows men who know about her, men that are probably older than her, won't take it. So this woman is a predator, Patrick. So when Patrick figured out this, he told John, you better stay away from that chick, she's not good. Now, in this example, you had a commoner who did not look at the bigger picture, and you had a pagan who saw the bigger picture without looking for it. Because his whole attitude is to see things in their entirety. Now, let's say now you have two commoners and you have this 22-year-old predator. In this case, the 22-year-old predator makes her move on both of them, and both of them think that they won the jackpot, only to find out that later on, those two guys, none of them know that the other also is living with the same chick. Later, they'll find out that, well, it was a trap. Not only are they drained financially, not only are they drained in their time because they spent so much time on this chick, instead of socializing with friends and meeting new people, as they should be, but also they now get all kinds of weird messages on social media of angry, frustrated men that want to have their way with this woman, but whom she declined. And those angry men now are focusing their frustration, their attention on those two teenagers. They don't really look like teenagers that much, but now those guys are now the target of violence. So that predator not only drains them in their time and in their finances, she also brought physical danger to them. And once physical danger arrived, she was gone. And now those two guys in the late teens are left to deal with violence. Violence from older men was frustrated. Now they have demonically possessed stalkers after them. Now, that pagan Patrick saw the bigger picture without looking for it, and he realized, oh dear, there's trouble here. He says immediately something's wrong with the situation. So pagans are paranormally alert. Now, this does not mean that pagans are by definition benevolent, because you have malevolent pagans out there who do evil things. Arguments against amongst pagans also. Okay, I'm not saying all pagans get along, but even when they don't get along, they prefer each other than common people. Why? Because pagans understand that common people are not reliable, and they're quite clear about it. Pagans, even when they can't stand one another, still have this basis upon which they treat each other with dignity, because they know that once negative energy backfires, you're in big trouble. Common people don't care about things backfiring onto them. Common people tend to go all the way to the end, harming themselves and everyone around them just to get what they want. That's common people. Common people, when they're triggered emotionally or mentally, and they go off, man, there are no borders, there's no limit the amount of damage that can come from one common individual that was there triggered. Now, I'm not saying all common people are dangerous, absolutely not, but common people in general, especially in groups, they can become quite dangerous. The pagan rulers, now I'm not talking about just pagans, the pagan rulers of this world know this. That's why dictators take advantage of this. You get what I'm saying here? Look, pagans who are paranormally aware can see danger coming from miles away, while commoners just can't see it, even if it's in front of them. And someone that can't or doesn't want to see danger in front of them in order to anticipate it are the types of people that eventually will endanger you when you keep pointing out the danger. That's why let me tell you what a lot of YouTubers did, making videos about the Illuminati, about conspiracy, all of that, even though they were doing the right thing by alerting people. Many of them were commoners, and they experienced personally the hard way how their own common people are. And then you have pagans who know what's going on, because there are a lot of pagans who are against the pagan rulers, even though they're both pagan. But the pagans that are against the pagan rulers do expose them, but often anonymously. Or they go against the pagan rulers by suggesting better things to the people. They don't just go out there talking about Illuminati, this and that, and pointing things out. Why not? Because pagans know common people are allergic for reality. Common people won't be relieved at all costs. They are relief seekers. Some of them are, how I would say, hardcore relief seekers. They are just plain wicked, reprobate. Pagans know this. And pagans know that once a narcissist is triggered, the narcissist will use the codependents around him or around her to make their move. And 9 out of 10 times, the enablers enable the danger. But often they don't want to see that they're enabling danger. They just want to be left alone. Common people, let me say this, pagans know this of common people. And pagans in general would rather put up with a believer being around than they would a commoner. Believers, those that are in agreement with Christ, because you have believers that operate just like commoners, believers who are in agreement with Christ, they have a mission. They have a mandate from the Heavenly Father. And they are occupied with doing the Father's will. so they will not be triggered and suddenly attack people or go after people. They won't, because they operate in the real safety. And pagans, even though they are in error, they can see the power coming from believers. And they see the restraining effect of the power on the common people. Don't you know that sometimes murder is prevented not because of good policing by the police forces, not because good conflict resolution skills of the population, not because people carry guns, but because it's a believer living in the area? It can be. There's a lot of murderous contention in environments. But because there's a believer living there, who walks 5 feet, the power that comes out of him frustrates people picking up knives or guns and shooting at each other. Now the rage is still there. The negative contention is still there, but it's hindered from working out because there's a believer walking around. So it can be that you have this store that's about to be robbed. The robbers already have their guns and already are planning to knock that store owner to the floor. But then you walk by the store. You have no intention of entering the store, but suddenly you walk by. And the power that comes out of you frightens the robbers. The robbers feel threatened intensely. And suddenly they leave the store. The store owner may not even be aware he was about to be robbed or even killed. But the robbers leave the store. You pass by. That's how powerful the presence of believers are. At least believers that agree with Christ. So when you walk by faith, you will encounter pagans that want to be around you. Why do they want to be around you and they are pagan? It's because they see things as they are. They see the power coming from you. And there are times pagans, thinking they're doing the right thing, will begin to work on your behalf. Yes, they will. Let me give an illustration. Let's say you are a male believer and you get things done because you walk in the supernatural. And you have these women that tend to want attention from you. Now you are just doing your job. You're not aware that they want to drain your attention. Now there's a pagan nearby who sees what's going on. And the pagan sees those women are like parasites. They will go very far just to drain your attention. So the pagan who doesn't agree with it, who's angry with the attitude of those common women, may take action against those common women on your behalf. You didn't ask for it. You don't even know that pagan, but that pagan, even though he does not agree with Christ, even though he doesn't agree with the gospel, he may act on your behalf. Not because he's your brother or sister in Christ, not because he wants any friendship with you, but because he is against what those common women are doing. And he sees your impact is beneficial to the human community. Yet people are taking advantage of it, using it for evil. That pagan, he may take actions on your behalf. And there are times the Holy Spirit will allow pagans to take action on your behalf. Not because the Holy Spirit needs them, but the Holy Spirit will use them without being aware of it in your advantage. Such things happen. Look, I'm not making this video to praise paganism, no. I'm just telling you, pagans are, in general, quite realistic. But pagan Christianity taught you that pagans are the enemy, that pagans will devour you. Now, there are pagans that are malevolent, who prey on other pagans also. You have those things going on, don't get me wrong here. You have inaugurated witches and inaugurated warlocks. Because remember, not all pagans are inaugurated, okay? But you have inaugurated witches and inaugurated warlocks that go out there on assignments to bring curse on the population or just make blood sacrifice, all of that. So you have those. Alright? But not all pagans will come after you. Most pagans just want to be protected from the negative wills of other people. They want to be protected from collective witchcraft. That is what most pagans just want. There are incorporated pagans that are out there doing Satan's work, and they know what they're doing, but most pagans don't. Now, they're still pagan. They're still in the negative because they're still paranormally active. They have much relief because they're paranormally active, but they're still wrong because they're still operating with dark forces. But they, by their own understanding, they'll do according to their understanding to fight evil. They'll endanger themselves, but they do it. Let me tell you one more thing here. There's one thing that the pagan rulers, and I'm not talking about pagans, I'm talking about what the pagan rulers are doing. Because the pagan rulers know they need to keep the human population alive in order to drain them. And the pagan rulers know that there are many people with bad instincts that will act out if they're not put in check. So the pagan rulers came with this system in which you have to work 36 to 40 hours a week, tiring yourself emotionally, mentally, and physically. Then you have the weekends to charge up again. Why did the pagan rulers come with this structure? Because this structure empties and drains people. And because the people are drained, they don't have any strength left to do any harm. That's the purpose behind it. And now you have pagans who understand this logic. So now you have just pagans in general. Even though they see that it's modern slavery, people are being exploited, they'll rather have that than that perpetrators from the common people can just have free time to just will whatever they will. Look, I'm not telling you to become a pagan, absolutely not. I'm telling you to learn from the practical attitude of pagans. That's what I'm telling you. It's a shame, kind of, that I have to say this. It should be pagans being inspired by believers, and it happens. But way too often, I see pagans being confused when it comes to believers, because they see that you have the real power in you, but you get along with the commoners that would devour you if they had the chance. Look, believers ought to be the source of inspirations to others. Unfortunately for now, believers need to learn to walk by faith. And that's why I use pagans as an example. Not so that you would become a pagan, not so you would become paranoid active, but I'm using the practical attitude of pagans to teach you and instruct you. Look, if you are in an environment where there's a lot of crime, you're safer amongst the pagan than you are amongst the common people. Alright? Because the pagan at least is aware and takes spiritual action to have a guard. The common people think they can do everything on their own, and they think that by so-called self-defense they can fix everything. So the commoners are delusional, but they don't want to see they're delusional, and they'll go off at you when you point out their delusion. Look, I'm going to close this video with this. If you are a pagan, listen to this, you need Christ, okay? You need the real power to operate in, not the counterfeit of the paranormal. If you're not a pagan and you're a believer, listen to this. Pay close attention to the people you have close to you. Watch the people around you. Don't walk in blind trust. Don't walk in blind affection towards others. Look at the bigger picture. Please. And remember, not everything that starts up good will end up good. Not every good beginning has a happy ending. That being said, agree with Christ and be at peace.